Doing a major overhaul of your saw? You'll want to install a cylinder gasket and O-ring kit. The cylinder gasket and O-ring kit consists of the intake gaskets, the exhaust gasket, and the fuel and oil tank O-rings. Gaskets should be replaced whenever a part that they seal is removed. When a gasket is reused, there's a good chance it won't reseal properly. This can allow dirt into the engine. If a gasket is reused between the carburetor and the cylinder, it could let extra air into the engine. This will cause the engine to run lean, which can quickly lead to serious engine damage. O-rings will break down as they age. When you are doing maintenance on your saw, you should inspect the O-rings for cracks and replace them as needed. Installing a cylinder gasket and O-ring kit is a repair that you can do yourself, and I'm going to show you how.
Hi, I'm Mark Socha.
Do-it-yourself repairs like these are easier than you might think. From lawn machines to cordless grills, kitchen mixers,
outdoor grills,
our how-to videos walk you through each repair from start to finish. So doing it yourself means never having to do it alone.
Let's get started.
I'll begin by removing the top cover. Now remove the air filter cover and the air filter. Now I can remove the air filter base. Now remove the throttle linkage. I'll pull the trigger so I can access the end of the linkage and pull it away from the trigger. The choke lever. The fuel lines. And the carburetor. Now remove the carburetor gasket. Now remove the carburetor adapter. It's held in place with four screws. The two top ones are quite easy to get to. You can use a Torx screwdriver to do that. But the bottom two, you can't reach a screwdriver in there. So what I'm using is a small ratchet with a socket drive. So I'll use the screwdriver on the top two screws and then switch over to my ratchet for the bottom ones. Now I'll disassemble the carburetor adapter assembly. There's three gaskets I'll be removing. First, this outer sleeve. Now I'll remove the three screws. And I can take the two halves apart, and that'll give me access to this inner gasket. On this half of the carburetor adapter assembly, there's another gasket. This is the cylinder gasket, and I'll use a razor blade to scrape it off. With all of the old gaskets removed, now I can reassemble the carburetor adapter assembly. I'll start with this internal gasket and just line it up with the groove inside the housing. Now I'll place these two halves back together and secure this assembly with the screws. Now I can replace this outer seal. And now I can install the rebuilt carburetor adapter back onto the chainsaw. I'll line up the cylinder gasket
And now I can install this assembly. And I'll secure it with the screws. Now install the intake tube onto the carburetor adapter. Now I can install the carburetor gasket, followed by the carburetor. I'll line the carburetor up with the intake tube and make sure I get a good seal there. I want to be careful not to fold over the intake tube. Now I'll reinstall the fuel lines. And I'll go ahead and install the choke lever. Now reinstall the throttle linkage. It goes into the hole on the carburetor. Then again, I'll pull the trigger and slide the linkage back into place. Now install the air filter base and the air filter. The air filter cover goes on last. Yeah, just like that. Now remove the muffler. I'll start with the spark arrestor cover. And behind it, the spark arrestor. Inside each of these holes is a screw that secures the muffler to the cylinder. I'll remove those screws. I'll remove the muffler gasket from the muffler. Depending on how cleanly it comes off of the muffler, you may need to use a scraper and scrape off any residual. Now reassemble the muffler assembly. First, I'll drop the screws back through the holes. Make sure they come out the other side. Now I can place the gasket over the screws. And replace the heat dam. Now this whole assembly can go back onto the saw. I'll line the screws with the holes on the cylinder and secure the muffler. Now I'll reassemble the spark arrestor. First the screen and then the cover. The last two O-rings in our gasket kit go to the fuel tank cap and the oil tank cap. I'll start with the fuel tank cap, remove it, and I'll use a little pick to remove the O-ring. I'll have to pull the lanyard from the tank, and I can take the O-ring off and install the new one. Place the lanyard back into the tank and reinstall the cap. Now do the same process on the oil cap. and I'll reinstall the top cover.
Be sure to check back often for new videos and expert advice.
If you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up
and leave a comment.